بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد خير خلق الله أجمعين، وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله. Dear brothers, today we will be studying about a great sahaba of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, سيدنا بلال ابن رباح الحبشي رحمة الله عليه رضي الله عنه. This great sahaba of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, this great sahaba of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who is an example of patience, an example of steadfastness, an example of beautiful akhlaq with which he's learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a beautiful life that he's lived, with which he loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam loved him also. Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah originated from Al-Habasha, which is now known as Ethiopia or that side, and also he said himself, ana innama ana habashiyun kuntu bil amsi abda. I am from Al-Habasha, originally I used to be a slave. So he was bought, he was owned by Umayyah ibn Khalaf, one of the great enemies of Islam, Umayyah ibn Khalaf, and he owned him, and then he met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has given him da'wah to join Islam, and Sayyidina Bilal, he joined Islam, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told him, you must hide your Islam for now, otherwise the non-believers will cause you so much pain and headache. And Sayyidina Bilal, rahmatullahi alayhi, my brothers, is an example of Islam at its very best. Islam at its very best. This is what we should tell people about Islam. His skin was a black skin, but with a beautiful white heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reason he created different kind of people, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ O people, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ We have created you من ذَكَرٍ in males, وَأُنْثَى females, وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا We've made you nations, وَقَبَائِلَ We've made you different tribes. The only reason for this particular purpose is لِتَعَارَفُوا Just to know one another, so that people do not confuse where one has come from. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ The best amongst you, the excellent amongst you, عِنْدَ اللَّهِ It was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَتْقَاكُمْ Is the one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most, is the best one. He's considered to be the best. Not someone who's lighter skin, not someone who's darker skin. It does not matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't look into that. Even a hadith narrated by Sayyidina Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, Ya Rasulullah, man akramun nas, who is the best amongst people? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Atqahum, is the one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. He is the one who is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also in a hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, He was speaking to the people at the time of Hajj. He said, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, ala inna rabbakum wahid, your Lord is one. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching people love. He said, all of you, you worship one Lord. You worship one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, wa inna abakum wahid, you're all originated from one father. Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam originated from Adam. This is what Islam at its very best is teaching us, to be inclusive. Everyone is the same. All of you are brothers. It does not matter your skin colors. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way He's created people, you can look even children from same mother. The mother will have five children. No two children sometimes will look alike. They will look different. You and your brother will look different. You and your sister will look different. One is short, one is tall, one is dark, one is light. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who creates, and He decides who is going to look like what. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, all your father, all you are from originated from one single father, and you worship one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala la fadla li arabiyyin ala ajamiy. He said, the one who's an Arab, he has no priority, or he's no better than the one who's not an Arab. Wala li ajamiyyin ala arabi. And someone who's not an Arab, he is no better than an Arab. Wala li ahmarin ala aswad. He said, no, somebody who's a red skin to a darker skin. Wala aswad ala ahmar illa bi taqwallah. And red skin is not better than the black skin, or black skin is not better than other skins. Illa bi taqwallah. It is only the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what differentiate people from being the good people and the best people. It is who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Jannah for those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and has created hellfire for those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, Abdan Habashiyan, a slave from Habasha, who was treated like items, who used to be sold, who did not have any future, who did not have any dreams. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inserted, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put nur of iman in his heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has changed his life and has given him hope, he's given him life, he's given him dreams. And so Jannah is for those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't matter whether they are poor, whether they are weak, whether they are dark skinned, whether they are light skinned, it does not matter. Islam is completely against racism. Islam is completely against looking down on others, disrespecting others. Islam is about love. Islam is about being together. That is why Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa, believers, all believers, truly they are brothers. A Muslim brother is your brother. That is what it teaches us. Islam teaches us about brotherhood. Let's tell people the truth about Islam. No one will learn Islam in its true version except he will love Islam, except he will love the Prophet ﷺ, except he will submit to this beautiful deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Jannah for those who worship him. For example, Sayyidina Bilal, who was weak, who was considered dark skinned, who was considered a slave with no life, no future, no dreams. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of his worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of his sacrifice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of his patience, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with Jannah. And also, those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't matter if you are in the tribes of Quraysh, the tribe of Makkah, the best tribes of Arabs with which the Prophet ﷺ also originated from, the Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, the Prophet ﷺ's uncle, who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who decided not to follow the Prophet ﷺ. It doesn't matter whether he's light skin, whether he has money, whether he has wealth, whether he is family ties or something, it will not help him completely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those kind of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the hellfire wal-iyadu billah. And also Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl is one of the leaders of the kufr, the non-believers. He said, how can Bilal be guided and we are the masters? I am the master. He said, he is just a slave. He doesn't know. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. It is Allah who guides whom he wishes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can guide whomever he wishes. So Sayyidina Bilal has lived a life, majority of life that is lived, it was life of slavery, where there was no rights. So there was no hope, there was no dreams. People were sold to one another. They were just treated like a commodity. They were just treated like furniture. People, you could just buy them and use them. They're yours. But Islam came to start abolishing that. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, along with other sahabas, they've given these people right. They've given them hope. They've given them dreams. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he's seen the way Umayyah ibn Khalaf was punishing him, the master or the owner of Sayyidina Bilal, Umayyah ibn Khalaf, the way he was punishing him and beating him. He was beaten so much that he was, in the evenings, he used to be put in chains and given to the children to drag him around the streets of Medina or Makkah, the streets of Makkah. During the day, they used to strip his clothes off and beating him with different kind of beatings, and also to an extent that he was so tired of beating him. And Sayyidina Bilal, one of beautiful words that he used to say, Ahadun Ahad, Allah is the only one. Allah is the only one. They used to tell him, turn your back against your God and turn your back against Muhammad. We leave you alone. He said, Ahadun Ahad, Allah is the only one. Allah is the only one. I am not turning my back. What he has done? Umayyah ibn Khalaf, one of the enemies of Islam, he has taken a big rock and is put on top of his chest wanting to kill him, and they were laughing at him while he's struggling to even breathe on the heat of Makkah. They've put a big mountain, big rock on his chest, yet he would remain steadfast, yet he would remain patient, because he knows why he is patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِرَبِّكَ فَصْبِرْ, because of your Lord, remain patient. And he's truly shown the example of patient. Sayyidina Bilal, he was getting punished like that, and he was about to die, but he would still say, أَحَدٌ أَحَدٌ, Allah is the only one, Allah is the only one. And then Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he came to Umayyah ibn Khalaf. He said, instead of killing him, why don't you sell him and make a little bit of money and finish with him? And he said, what are you going to give me? And he said, small amount of gold. He said, I was so tired beating him. For example, let's give an example as money. He said, buy him of me for £5. He said, I was so tired of beating him. He said, even if you have given me £1, I would have given it to you. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he said, after buying him, he said, even if you've asked me for 100, I would have given it to you. He is so valuable to us. Sayyidina Bilal, Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu ardah, he is the one who bought him and set him free. Islam started buying them, and Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq started using his wealth, buying these weak people who did not have money, who were getting punished, who were slaves. He used to use his money to buy them and free them. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى, that hellfire, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be saved from that. الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى, the one who gives his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he gives his zakat. وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى, he's not doing anything of these things that he's doing for the sake of somebody, except he is doing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى, he shall be happy for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr, that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, promised him Jannah. So as soon as he was freed, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has taken Sayyidina Abu Bakr, has taken Sayyidina Bilal to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with all the injuries, the blood dropping out of his body and beatings and the wounds of the body. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showing a beautiful example, he said, he's hugged him so much like someone who hugs his son or his child who he has not seen for so long. He has hugged him and brought him close to his heart and shown him love. And Sayyidina Bilal was one of the first few to join Islam. In fact, it is said he is the seventh to join Islam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina, Sayyidina Bilal also migrated along with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he arrived in Medina, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam built a mosque. And then after that, he sat with the Sahabas, and then they decided that they have to call people towards the prayer. And people were bringing different opinions. some of the opinions, they said, let's call people towards prayer the way the Christians do that. And others, they said, the way the Jews called towards their prayers. But one of the Sahabas of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abdullah ibn Zayd, he has seen a dream. In his dream, he was taught the full adhan, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Hayya ala salati, Hayya ala falah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I seen this dream about adhan. He said, that is exactly what it should be. Go and teach Bilal, who has a beautiful, big voice. Go and teach him. MashaAllah. What an honor to be the first muadhin in history of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the first muadhin of Islam. And he has performed the adhan for about 10 years, Sayyidina Bilal. He was so beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One of the most important thing that happened to Sayyidina Bilal is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, when I was taken to the seven heavens to be given the Salat, Al-Isra' al-Mi'raj, he said that I went to Jannah. He said, I went to the paradise and I heard your footsteps. You are walking in Jannah. Bilal, what have you done to have gone to Jannah before us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he said, what have you done? What good deed that you have done to so that I heard you to be the people of Jannah? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I always remain in the state of wudu. Whenever my wudu breaks, I take wudu. And also whenever I take wudu, I pray two raka'ah of wudu. This is great sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam agreed with it. And the sahabas, ever since they were performing this sunnah, which was seen from Sayyidina Bilal, and we performed that, alhamdulillah, and it will be performed until the day of judgment, insha'Allah. And then Sayyidina Bilal, wow, beautiful gift that is received because of that patience, steadfastness, and the love for Allah, the love of Prophet self-sacrifice that he has done because of this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Bilal, in the battle of Badr, he has seen that great enemy, the Umayyah ibn Khalaf, who used to be his master, who used to punish him, who used to beat him with metals, who used to put a rock onto his chest, and who used to put chains and give to children to drag him on the street of Makkah. He has seen him in that battle, and he want to kill the Muslims. Sayyidina Bilal, he said, La najawtu in naja, I will not be saved if he is saved. I must make sure that I finish him. And he is gone after him. And this Umayyah ibn Khalaf, he has seen Sayyidina Bilal coming. And Sayyidina Bilal was the reason of killing this great enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And great enemy of him, great enemy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was killed by Sayyidina Bilal, rahmatullahi alayhi wa radiyallahu anhu. And also look at the beauty of Islam. Look at the words of wisdom from Sayyidina Umar, showing that no one is better except those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sahabas, they've implemented what they've learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Look at Sayyidina Umar. He said, and Sayyidina Umar was one of the leaders of Quraysh, and also a great Arab, and also Sayyidina Umar, when Iman immersed his heart, when Iman covered him, he was covered with the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love of the Prophet, the love of this deen. No longer did he treat Sayyidina Bilal like a slave, he treated him like a master, because Islam teaches people to be equal. Everyone to be equal. That those are the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We worship one Lord, we worship one God, and also we are from the same Father. It does not matter what kind your color skin. Subhanallah, what a beautiful lecture, what a beautiful lesson that we could learn today, where people are hating one another because of their skin colors. People are hating each other because of their tribes. People are hating each other because of different sects. Subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of Islam, has teach people love, has teach people peace. And the Prophet of Islam has taught people how to respect one another. It doesn't matter whether you are a slave. Sayyidina Umar, look at the words of wisdom. He said, Abu Bakr Sayyiduna, Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Abu Bakr is our master, wa a'taqa Sayyidana, and he is left free for the sake of Allah, our master, Sayyidina Bilal. He started calling him our master, and he is one of the great people of Quraysh. Allahu Akbar. That is because of Iman. And also on the day of Fath Makkah, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam conquered Makkah along with almost 10,000 of his army of the Sahabas in the year 8 of Hijriyah, Islamic calendar year, in the year 8, when they've entered Makkah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked around and he said, where is Bilal? Look at how much he's been honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and loved by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, where is Bilal amongst all those people? He said, where is Bilal? And then Sayyidina Bilal, he said, I am here, Ya Rasulullah. He said, go on top of the Kaaba. Go on top of the Kaaba after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahabas removed all the statues on top of the Kaaba. He said, go on top of the Kaaba, Ya Bilal, perform the Adhan. Perform the Adhan, Allahu Akbar. What an honor that Sayyidina Bilal got to go on top of the Kaaba, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and perform the Adhan. While he performed the Adhan with his beautiful voice, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started remembering all the punishment the Sahabas used to get in Makkah, all the problems he used to get in Makkah from the enemies of Islam, the enemies of Allah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started crying, having heard Sayyidina Bilal performing freely the Adhan and no one bothering him. And then there were some people who were not non-believers. When they seen Sayyidina Bilal given that honor going on top of the Kaaba, they had hatred of him. He said, he is a slave. Yesterday we used to buy him and sell him. Today he's got this honor in front of all this ummah. And he has been chosen to go on top of the house of Allah, the Kaaba, to perform the Adhan. Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Bilal, why did he get all this? Because of his patience. Why did he get all of this? Because of his steadfastness, because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, following the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when the news have come of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Bilal, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died at Salatul Fajr. Then Salatul Dhuhr, Sayyidina Bilal had to perform the Adhan. When he started performing the Adhan before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was even buried, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died on Monday and he was buried on Wednesday. And then Sayyidina Bilal, when he reached Ashhadu Anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, all those beautiful memories that he had of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started flooding in his head. And he started crying and crying. He could not, he broke down. He could not continue with the Adhan. He cried, and the people around him also cried. And also Sayyidina Bilal, he said to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he said, let me go in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because I can no longer continue with this job of performing Adhan. I would not perform Adhan for anyone after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Sayyidina Bilal migrated to Sham, Damascus, and then he stayed there to do the work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do da'wah. Once while he was asleep, he seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his dream. He said, oh Bilal, why did you not come to visit us for so long? It's been so long. Come to Medina and visit us. Immediately that night, when he woke up, he got up and then he got ready and he went to Medina to visit the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then the Sahabas, they've asked him to perform the adhan. When he started performing the adhan of Salat al-Fajr, Sayyidina Bilal started to perform the adhan and people started to cry. They remember the beautiful days when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive. And Sayyidina Bilal, when he got to Ashhadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah, then he broke down out of love, out of the memories that he remembered of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he broke down. He could no longer continue. And then Sayyidina Bilal, he would not, after that, perform adhan. Once, in the last adhan that he performed, it is said, it is when Sayyidina Umar has taken over the Baytul Maqdis, and the Muslims there, they've asked him to come along with Sayyidina Bilal and perform the adhan. Perform the adhan for the last time once more. Sayyidina Umar has requested Sayyidina Bilal to come and perform the adhan at the time of Salat. And Sayyidina Bilal started performing the adhan and he started crying. And the Sahabas were crying when they started remembering the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And amongst those who were crying the most was Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. Sayyidina Bilal, at the time of his death, he was not well, and then his wife, having looked at him, he said, "Oh my Bilal, oh my sadness that Bilal is leaving me." He said, "Do not say my sadness." He said, "Oh my happiness, say my happiness. Tomorrow I am going to meet the loved ones. Tomorrow I'm going to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba." That is how much conviction he had of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him. Sayyidina Bilal passed away, and he died in Ard Bilad al-Sham, and is buried there, and he died in the 20th year of Islamic calendar month, and also just about 9 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. And one of the beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Jannah is in love and it cannot wait